We're all tired and hungover, and we have some people to blame for that. And so the organizers had the good idea of picking this session as the last one, since it's mostly demos and things that move and shine. It should be fairly easy to follow, hopefully. So basically, I just wanted to use this session give an update on where SVG and related web technologies around it are today. SVG has been around for about a decade now. At least it's been in development for over a decade. And it has this bizarre situation where it's somewhat successful. It's in a lot of browsers. Last year, it shipped 1 billion implementations in cell phones, which is quite a good thing. It's in Firefox, Opera, WebKit, etc. It's exported by Illustrator, and so on and so forth, but no one's using it for some reason. It gets very little usage. So the situation isn't ideal, but it's better than it was 2 or 3 years ago. Notably, there were all sorts of bad politics about MPEG trying to take over SVG and swallow it up, and that hasn't happened. And the conformance is much better today. And actually, we've reached the point where support in browsers is good enough that you can use it in situations where you know that it degrades gracefully to Internet Explorer, or if you have an API that allows you to, a small script that allows you to alternate content. For instance, Google Analytics in some browsers uses SVG to display the graphics and the charts and things like that. Washington Post uses SVG for a system of related articles and things like that. And I've been testing it quite a lot recently, and the support has become pretty good. The improvements that came with the last version of SVG, which is 1.2, and that was released in December last year. Basically, better graphics. Before that release, we couldn't do things like on mobile. Well, let me backtrack a little bit. The baseline of SVG that people can and actually do use is defined by the mobile profile. So some things were possible outside of the mobile, but when people do SVG, a lot of the time they want it to work on phones and on desktops. So one of the improvements is better graphics. The SVG Tiny now supports gradients and things like that. It integrates video and audio, so you don't need to have an object with a plugin to support video. Playback, it means you can control it directly with an API in the DOM. It matches Smile, so you can have animation events fired off from the video. Again, scripting was in the full version, but it wasn't on the tiny version, so that always hurts adoption. Now the baseline has scripting, and generally the spec has been massively cleaned up compared to the previous version. And while that probably doesn't matter directly to people, it certainly helped implementers do a much better job of showing the same thing for any given file. Interoperability is now getting really, really much better. In browsers, it's not perfect, but it's getting seriously there. And it's not just SVG on its own that's interesting. Actually, SVG on its own is just vector graphics. It starts to become more interesting when you start being able to use SVG as part of something else, and I'll be showing demos of that right afterwards. For instance, you can now use in some browsers, so all of these things are features that are being deployed now and take some time to catch up. So they're not always the same everywhere, but it grows fast. But this is using SVG as a CSS background allows you to have a shape that actually grows with the background in the HTML and can fill it correctly and can keep a nice fine line without having to use 19 different images to get something to work. Same thing, clipping and masking is basically the operation of hiding something, and you can now do that on any kind of HTML content. filtering, which is basically bitmap level operations. And as I'll show later, these things become really, really interesting when you mix them up with HTML. For instance, I was playing with having an H1 element contain text on a path so that you could have the titles on your document just go like this and stay text. They stay completely text, and you can use fonts, which means you can now have nice typography on the web, which is always useful. And I'll basically be showing these things afterwards. Also, I wanted to point out that things are moving ahead in terms of both tooling and standardization. There are better SVG production tools today. It's still not perfect, but it's moving forward. And one of the things that's going on that's interesting and that's really helping with the browser integration is that SVG is currently being integrated into HTML5 and is expected to still be defined by the SVG people, but to become an integral part of HTML, which is very good in terms of convincing browser people to actually support it and support it correctly. And finally, now that we have 10 years experience of things that work and things that really don't work, there's talk about doing a more massive cleanup and killing off all the features that no one uses to try and make something simpler, smaller, easier to learn, and more implementable. So, some demos. What should I start with? So this is a video. This is just showing that clipping can work on any kind of content. Basically, you have an HTML page behind that's playing a video, and I'm just moving around to show that basically clipping is operational here, and you can animate it. This is pure HTML plus SVG. What next? So this basically shows the operations that you can do on text with filtering and animation, clipping, and this is basically real HTML text that can be clipped and moved around and rotated multiple times and animated, etc. And I'm not a graphic, I don't do pretty things, but this is really easy to actually put together. It's not that much code. Currently, one of the big problems is the Czech people are laughing for some reason. Currently, browsers are not really well optimized, but it's getting a lot better. It's some of the work that's been done in optimizing JavaScript is helping SVG a lot, and some implementations are becoming pretty good. I mean, for instance, WebKit on iPhones runs SVG, and it's actually, if you do something really complex like filters or something crazy like that, it will be slow. But it's rather impressive how some fairly normal stuff that moves around, hides things, uses transparency, all those features, is actually fairly decently fast even on this. This is basically showing what I was explaining earlier about the ability to use text on the path. This is real text. You can select it. You can find for it. Oops. Normally you should be able to find for it. For some reason doesn't like it there. This is a better version of Opera, so there are bugs.
Can you share source?
Sure. This is basically just SVG. But I can show you if I find it, I can show you the same thing using SVG plus HTML, which would be somewhere in here. So basically, this is if I show you this source, you see this is you see three. Hang on, this should help. So this is just the first H1, which is just not a regular H1. This is an H1 containing some SVG, and that puts this is a text path that references the path that's defined here up there, and just putting the text there makes it wiggle. And then this is a version that just uses directly HTML, but there's a script out there that does the same thing as the second, but behind the scenes, so that you can still keep using your HTML as if it were normal and regular, and just squirrel a little script into there, and you will get the third one, or the second one. So and this is the kind of trick that currently people have to go to images or Flash to use today, because designers always want to get creative with titles on pages. And right now it means that using this on three browsers out of four, you will get the wavy thing, and it falls back properly in Internet Explorer. You'll just get a regular title, which you can still style. So let me try to show something. Hang on. So basically, this is showing video integration. You can now use video directly inside SVG, and it's fully animated. You can rotate it. It's part of the page. It really works. And the whole idea, I mean, is really to make sure that features can work together, as opposed to having a plugin which you couldn't rotate because it writes to the screen directly and things like that. This makes interaction of features possible. It's not new to see video in a browser, but it's new that you can actually do useful stuff with it without having to go entirely into Flash. Let me try to show something else. I think that's...
Which version of Opera are you running?
I'm running 9.62 or something like that, which is an Opera Labs version. You can't get it officially, I think.
And the other browsers, is there level of support anywhere near this?
Firefox 3.1, which is currently a sort of alpha beta, has that level of support. Safari 4, also beta, has comparable support. It's actually getting to be pretty decent today. Internet Explorer. come on. Yeah, so basically this shows, this is a demo from Fuchsia Design. Again, it shows the video, how it integrates with everything else. You can clip it, and you can have transparency overlaid on top of it. It's fully integrated with the language. And that gives you funny things. So for instance, this is the same video, and as I was saying earlier, SVG has bitmap level filters that can apply to anything. And in fact, the text at the top with the little effect to make it look like more Web 2.0 gimmicky, this is actually a filter. This is real text. And it's just flipped over and reused with a filter that applies a gradient. It's fairly simple. And so, but you can also apply filters live in real time to the video. Or grayscale. And going back to the original, or tracing edges again. And this is a very simple example, but there are plenty of filters that can be used, and they can be combined and parameterized. So you can start doing fairly interesting stuff. And yes, the CPU on this is fairly bad. That will not work on the iPhone. but it's still interesting, the kind of effects. And this This has only been manipulated currently by geeks. If you know, if people who actually had some talent for design were to put their hands on this, they would probably be able to do something a lot more impressive, because every time that we add features to the web stack, we find out that designers come up with absolutely amazing ideas. And this adds quite a few features. Right, so again, video fully integrated. You can resize, flip, play with it in a number of ways. And I just wanted to show you this. This is not SVG, this is Canvas. But basically, this is just done entirely, this is a 3D engine done entirely in JavaScript. So you could implement a game, and the way that Opera supports it now, even though it's not complete, they allow you to use SVG as a texture in their 3D support, which means you can show actually animated SVG plus video on something that moves around, which is completely controlled by script. It's fairly impressive. Now let's look at some. So I originally wanted to show you things directly on the mobile, which is difficult, but we could have used something like that. But the problem is the mobile I have that's not this iPhone, but that does mobile SVG in interesting ways is completely broken because it's Windows Mobile. Don't buy Windows Mobile. But I have some videos that at least show the similar stuff. So this is basically a complete user interface for a phone. Everything's SVG, just absolutely everything. And this is running on a phone fairly decently. The pseudo 3D that you're seeing is actually using an extension to SVG that's currently being looked at in standards. The idea is not, as I was saying yesterday, to add a Z attribute everywhere there's X and Y, but it's just to support, so here's a CoverFlow-like system. Basically, the idea is to support non-affine transforms so that you can emulate 3D easily with a 2D content. So basically, as you see, it's a normal phone. It's just, this is a Samsung phone. And it's been released in Korea at the end of last year, I think October, I forget. So this also shows usage with widgets. As you probably know, widgets are becoming fairly intensively pursued. Basically, they're just small mobile applications that can do all sorts of stuff and that are built using SVG and HTML. This is all SVG widgets. That are basically, it's like the app manager for the entire phone, and you can just build those new applications using SVG. The standard is coming out later this year. It's in last call, and there's a big push by all the operators and vendors to actually support that kind of small widget application on phones everywhere, so that everyone could use them and not just not build special things for each different platform. And I have a few other things, but they're not really as funny. I could probably show you the widgets more extensively. So again, this is the same idea, except it's a different widget manager. You just drag things out, and all of that is done in SVG, and this is a capture straight off the phone, basically. As you can see, it's in Korean. And some fonts are missing. The idea is really to enable the creation of simple applications using web technology that you can ship everywhere without depending on a given platform or anything else. So it's like Java, except they got it right. And I believe that's pretty much it. Do you have any questions or? Yes. Sorry? Currently not. I'm in talks with the implementers who are behind the stuff to try and get them to push them out on their website so that everyone could actually use them. The problem with that is that they then have to ask permission from the designers and from Samsung, so it's taking a while. I was hoping that we could get them in time for this conference, but unfortunately, the Samsung being a fairly big company, it's difficult. But we're in talks. We're trying to get more examples out there that people can actually use. It would be nice. Yes. So the question is, if I wanted to create an application today that would run on the greatest number of phones, what would I use? The answer is, today, right now, I really don't know. It's still very split up. You could use something like PhoneGap, for instance, which allows you to basically build your applications in HTML and ship them to iPhone, Android, and I think Nokia Series 60 now. And basically have access to a limited set of APIs from the device in JavaScript. But that's the reason why the widget effort is taking off. It's because people want to build applications that just run everywhere easily. The Java stack has pretty much failed in mobile because it's completely not interoperable. There are many issues. You never know which JSR is going to be present. And basically, the idea with widgets is to do something simple, but that can work everywhere easily, in that it's basically just a zip file with a small manifest, and the rest is HTML, JavaScript, SVG, and CSS. And once you have that, you can be pretty confident that it can be made to run anywhere. And there's an effort on top of that to expose the device-level APIs to JavaScript in a coherent and standard manner. That's currently done in OMTP, Open Mobile Terminal Platform, and I've been fairly involved in that. And the standard will ship this year. The phones with that sort of level of support will start shipping this winter, basically. So right now, I don't know, but we're working on it. we're getting there. Kaveh?
Can I pass on a question from the people who are watching the webcast?
Oh, yeah, sure.
You're late to the
You told a friend to go to the website to ask the question, right? Right, so the question is there a test suite to ensure compatibility as there is for, as there's the ACID test and the test suite for CSS? The answer is it's not perfect, but the test suite that shipped with the latest version of SVG is already much better than the previous one, and people keep feeding tests to it, especially as browser vendors find bugs and find issues, they tend to feed us tests on a regular basis. And also, there is work on an SVG ACID test. And I believe that SVG will be or has been integrated in the latest version of the ACID test. So basically, the ACID test now tests that browsers support SVG as well.
That question?
Any other question?
I have one.
Oh, no, not you. Yeah, you mean SVG itself, or more the whole shebang?
Dynamic things.
Yeah, things that move, and yes, there's a fair amount of effort in the Open Ajax Alliance to enable the creation of JavaScript libraries that people could reuse easily. to integrate with IDEs so that people could develop in a more visual manner. I know that Aptana has done a lot of work around that. Also, of course, for SVG, you can create your SVG in Illustrator because it saves to SVG. And Adobe, despite the fact that they prefer Flash for some reason, tend to actually improve the SVG support in the Creative Suite with pretty much every release. So they're certainly not stopping support for that. There's also a few tools like Arkivo, which is a Swedish company that does implementations of SVG for mobile phones. They have two authoring tools that are pretty good. One is an animation tool that basically allows you to take directly out of Illustrator or any other graphics program and start animating things. And the other is an IDE that's in development that works inside Eclipse and will emulate a phone so that you can do SVG development for it. Again, it's one of those things that are not perfect, but they're definitely moving forward. I'm personally working on a way to export SVG from Flash and Flex, because I do think it's possible, but it's taking a while, and I'm doing it in my spare time. Any other questions? Are you really too tired?
No, thank you.
Thank you. Before I yield the floor to Mohammed, I would like to thank the organizers for what has been a really kick-ass conference. Good job, guys.